So I edited another episode of the vlog from that time frame where the wheel wasn't acquired yet, the motor rather, replacement. And yeah, it is weird going back, experiencing that again. I'll make sure I have my belongings on me. Yeah, I have them all. Come on, go ahead. Go ahead. I'm literally waiting for you. After I tuned it, they were still hesitating. So I think we, just take a ride maybe to Allison Park. A little breezy though, cloudy breezy. I don't know if that's a good spot to ride to. I did not check the temperature. Maybe one of the next traffic lights I'll check. I'll edit out of the vlog, right? But it does feel comfortable. I checked with the assistant about the weather earlier, about asking it if it would rain. It insisted no, but not until Tuesday. Yeah, I couldn't hear the temperature thing because for some reason the assistant is designed to extremely lower the volume on the assistant voice. You can play the music all the way to deafening volumes, but you can't raise the assistant voice. So I'm like, okay. And why in a Bluetooth headset, when you're mobile, you're specifically using a Bluetooth headset, most likely for safety. And they lower the volume on the assistant. So I tried once again to raise the volume. And yeah. So I had a quiet spot where I could hear the assistant whispering. It's 76 degrees. And that's not too bad. Somebody's rude alarm. Stay Gold by Paris just came up on my headset, my media player. Go up this way. Check the rear view. There's a nasty bump back there. Feel it right through your hips and your spine. This Jeep shadowing me, so I'm gonna let him pass me. So I've been uploading the series of vlogs from the downtime from the big bike, and you know, riding the Anchor, the backup bike. And so I've been editing them furiously. Like I hand selected a few episodes, and I've been uploading one after another after another after another, day after day, sometimes two a day. Because my intention, as you've seen from how I publish them, was to publish them as a continuous series, a few days in a row. And you know, I don't want to like upset the internet provider, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to cache a few episodes. In my storage. And I'll upload them from now on, you know, kind of split up. Curious how that scenery is gonna look with the partially darkened sky from atop the overlook. Usually I'll take a selfie or two up there, and the bike in the background or something, you know. put on my furious blinking lights. We'll make the lefticle. EUCs. Going into New York. Or maybe they're returning to New York. Now, some people talk about e-bikes being in a gray area and all that stuff. I think EUCs definitely are in a gray area. There's no doubt about it. Because, actually, I don't think there's any actual rules that describe an EUC and all that. So, I don't know. They look fun as hell, but I'm scared of EUC, personally. I'm scared of having a spill on an EUC. And it would be my luck that I'd wipe out. You get the road cyclists. The mountain bikers riding down here, this path. They'll ride up this way and then turn by 9W and head north into upstate New York. We gotta chill here. clear the road. And we have Allison Park coming up. I'm going to drop the gears down, drop the velocity. Speed bump ahead. They're not joking about the speed bump. It's pretty serious. Look at a pit stop. Driving over the acorns here, so we're gonna head out. Gonna head back. Back on the road. I had the front bike wheel light come off. I guess the last time I changed the batteries, I didn't clamp it correctly on the spokes. There's a certain way you clamp on, and it holds more sturdy. So we got a bit of a tailwind. I did get lucky that the bike wheel light came off at the park. Literally when I pulled over and I rolled the bike, that's when it came off. There's a certain way of clamping the bike wheel light that it uses its own leverage to hold itself across two spokes. And it kind of locks in place. You're doing it. We gotta make sure we didn't lose that bike wheel light again. I'm gonna pull over here at the crest of the hill here. Right here. To make sure we didn't lose that. Oh, we got it. Alright. I ran over some like plastic or glass. And I wasn't sure if that was the bike wheel light popping off. I think we'll take Main Street. The local regional coffee shop. I mean, they're high enough that probably not gonna rain, but they still look kind of full and ominous. Mild. The sun's not beating down on me, so I don't feel like overheated or anything. Doors opening. And the fountains. Yeah. Oh, they rip up the roadway. Probably changing the pipes. downhill action. We'll be leaving Anderson Avenue soon and reaching Bergeline Avenue. We've gone 13.7 miles. Well, my bike wheel light stayed on, so I got it clamped on better now, more correctly. Finally. I gotta be more careful with that when I change the batteries. So we are on Bergeline. That's Hudson County Park over there. That's all Phoenix Bakery. We've gone 14.6 miles. We've gone 15 miles. Coming down the home stretch. Traffic is kind of moderate, typical. Gone 15 and a half miles. So don't miss out on days like this for riding. They're actually not bad. This is a Friday. And the weather is cooperating. So make the most. Of your e-bike. Be safe, though. Be careful. Keep it maintained, check your brakes, check your tires. Make sure you have tire liner. Some kind of flat seal. Use butyl rubber tire tubes. And did I mention to use tire liner? Use tire liner. And wear a helmet. Dagnabbit. So, with that, that's going to be the ride. That's going to be the vlog.